Is anybody in here ready tonight? I want you to throw both of your hands up in the air, and you've got to shout like you know your miracle is on the way. I want you to tell somebody next to you, better give me some room, because I'm about to get a miracle.
Yeah.
Put your hands together, come on. Woo. Here we go. Say thanks be.
Yeah.
because there's nothing you can do to stop it. I want to see some victory, people. Give God some praise in here. See some victory, people. Who knows it's already done? Lift up your voice and shout, I've already got the victory.
I've already got the victory.
Touch about five people around you and say, you better shout now because you've already got the victory. It was finished, and it's still finished tonight. You better shout like you know. You're already healed, already delivered, already set free. That your mama's already saved. That your husband's already. Next to you and say, I win. The devil loses. Somebody lift up a hallelujah in the house.
Hallelujah. Yes.
Ha. I told some folks before we began, said the devil's already a loser because he told you you weren't going to make it here tonight, and here you are. I said, here you are. Look at somebody next to you and say, here you are.
And we're expecting miracles, signs, wonders, and mighty deliverances in the name of Jesus. Somebody say yes. Everybody standing with me, please, all across this great tabernacle. You know, every time the devil raises up an Ahab, God raises up an Elijah, not just to oppose him, but to overcome him. And it doesn't matter what culture has done. It doesn't matter what the world is doing. Thank God, God is doing some great things. And one of the things that he's done is he's raised up a man of God to not only oppose but overcome the influence of the world here in this house. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome our host, Pastor Rod Parsley.
Praise the Lord, everybody. That's terrible. Praise the Lord, everybody. Reach way, 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 way down. Get a hallelujah he had never heard before. Get that hallelujah. He tried to stop. He tried to block. He had tried to hinder. But look at you tonight, standing there after everything he tried to do, with your happy head, heart, and hands lifted up, giving glory to the King above all kings. I'm so glad to see you tonight. We have drawn a line in the sand. I've been waiting, anticipating, and I still believe it. The atmosphere of expectancy is the breeding ground of miracles. Tonight, this night, this moment, this accepted time, this solemn assembly, we have declared and decreed by the Spirit of the Lord, one touch changes everything. Tonight, when we came into 2007, I was like every other preacher. I said seven, that's the number of completion. Boy, I preached it till I got about June. And everything seemed to be falling apart. Now, how many of you going to be honest and testify just a little bit that about the only way to describe your 2007 was from the pit? Yeah. You were brought into the valley. But I've got a word for you tonight. The valley is not where God sent you to die. The valley is where your giants came to die. There's about to be a shift. Shove somebody on the shoulder and shout, shift, a transition. No. You still too tight. This is miracle healing and victory. Prayer call service. Yes, 300,000 prayer calls on that altar tonight. 12,500 intercessors around the world right now calling on the name of God. And I said in the 12th month of the 8th year, when 7 becomes 8, 8 is a shift. Something's about to happen. It's irreversible. No, you didn't hear what I just said. The book of Ezekiel declares that what God does, he does forever. And he's about to make a shift, a transition in your life that is irreversible. It is undeniable. Let me help you this way. He's about to turn your water into wine. And that's not the miracle. The miracle is once he does it, it's never going back to water again. You need to go to your phone. Go to rodparsley.com. Those of you watching around the world right now, because when the atmosphere of expectancy becomes the breeding ground of miracles, we've got some prayer calls in here that don't have a name on them yet, we're going to put your name on them. We're going to believe God for your miracle, for your healing, for your victory. And then when this 24 hours is over, I'm going to send that prayer cloth to you. Why? To become a point of contact. Shout contact. No, that was really weak. Shout contact. I'm going to give you one more chance. Shout contact. Do you know what happens when contact is made? There is a demand placed on the supply. How many of you need something just beyond your trembling hand? I said, how many of you need something just beyond your trembling hand? We're about to make contact because the anointing is tangible. And if it's tangible, it's transferable. It was in Moses' rod, Elijah's mantle. It was in Elisha's bones. It was in Jesus' robe. It was in Peter's shadow. It was in Paul's handkerchiefs and aprons. The verifiable DNA of God Himself is about to eternally redeem everything that is broken, everything that is missing in your life. This is no ordinary moment. This is no ordinary time. This is the time when now becomes forever. Heart conditions are being healed now. Ringing in the ears being healed now. There's a crippling arthritis being healed right now. In fact, you just got the report in the last 12 days. There's a catch in the neck. You haven't been able to turn your neck for many, many months, but it's loose now. Everybody shout loosed. The anointing is tangible. It's transferable. And it is yoke destroying and burden removing. And if you believe that, shout hallelujah. Tonight it breaks. Tonight it leaves. Tonight the burden is lifted. Tonight your child is healed. Tonight your spouse gives their life to Christ. This is the night of breakthrough. It's a night of miracles. Tonight. Tonight. God said to me, in the 12th month of the year, when the 7 becomes 8, when the day 7 becomes the day 8, you may not realize it, my dear brother and sister, but it is absolutely the fact. God is a God of timing. God is a God of places. You can't get at Beth Ovin what you can get at Beth El. We were supposed to conduct this meeting this year in New York City. And after I saw well over 5,000 people give their lives to Jesus in 6 weeks at this altar, I said, no, 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 no. God is a God of timing. God is a God of purpose, a plan, of intention. God's a God of places. From right here in this great tabernacle in Columbus, Ohio, where the blind see and the lame walk and the deaf hear, marriages are put back together and addictions are broken. Every time we come through the doors of this tabernacle, I said, I'm going to join together 8,000, but we ended up with over 12,000 intercessors praying from this morning through tomorrow night for 24 hours to make the transition from 7 to 8. Giants are joining us tonight. Kenneth and Gloria Copeland are praying and fasting. Marilyn Hickey is praying and fasting. Andre Robert in South Africa is praying and fasting. Bishop John Francis and his entire congregation over in the United Kingdom are praying and fasting. And I'm just here to tell you
Tonight is the night you truly come to the realization that you have been eternally redeemed. I sense the anointing of the Holy Spirit now. Would you just lift your hands? Would you just lift your hands? I want to encourage you that are watching live around the world right now. I want you to go to your phone, go to rodparsley.com, and let us send you one of these prayer cloths. Father, in the name of Jesus, I speak an atmosphere overwhelmingly supernaturally charged with the tangibility of your anointing. Reclaim ministries tonight. Redeem marriages tonight. Break bondages tonight. Heal the sick and afflicted. Lord, we declare from this place, we still believe in miracles. Do it tonight, and we'll give you the glory for it. Put your hands together and give God a hallelujah that rings through the corridors of heaven. The breakthrough singers are coming. They're going to bless you with a song that says, "In Christ alone." You may be seated.
In Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my soul.
This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are still, when striving cease. My comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stay.
In Christ alone, who took on flesh, fullness of God in helpless faith.
This gift of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones he came to save.
Till on that cross where Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. For every sin on him was laid. Here in the death of Christ
there in the ground is fire.
I bind every alcoholic spirit, every drug addiction spirit. I bind every eating disorder. In the name of God's Christ, I bind stomach ulcers. I command ears to be open now. We're not waiting. The presence and the power of God is here to heal. Knees are being healed. Ankles are being healed. Shoulders are being healed. No scheme of man, no power of hell shall ever pluck you from his hand. His delivering power is your I bind that gambling spirit. I command it to loose your mind, loose your home. Come out in the name of Jesus. Somebody shout now.
No power of hell, no scheme of
be seated. Somebody's refusing to be refused. Somebody is denying to be denied. Somebody is about to realize Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. If he ever healed anybody, he'll heal you tonight. If he ever put anybody's marriage back together, I bind that homosexual spirit that's tormenting your life now. I command it, come out in the name of Jesus. Give me just a moment. Allow me, please, if you will. Peter and John, your Bible said, some folks, you know, they say, well, a prayer cloth, that's rather strange. You know, we've become sophisticated. We're smarter, but we're not wiser. We know more, but we understand less. Make no mistake about it, he is still a faith God. And he is not some other kind of God. I am determined that possibly next year, I won't have a miracle healing and prayer cloth service. I think maybe I'll become a little more sophisticated. And Dr. Lowry, I won't take, you know, things so literally. Maybe I'll just follow Jesus' example and get me a bunch of buckets of dirt and go to spitting in them and make clay out of it and put it on. I speak to eye conditions now. Now blurred vision is going. Floaters in your eyes are going now. Lazy eye healed by the power of God. Oh, cataracts. Everybody lay your hands on your eyes right now. Everybody, 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 everybody. When I say three, shout me. Listen, this thing's not complicated. It's not complicated. Lay your hands on your eyes, and when I say three, say, I receive the healing virtue of God into my eyes. One, two, three. Now act like it's done, act like it's done, act like it's done, act like it's done. Show God you take him at his word. Oh my God. Why did they do that? Why did they do that?
Why did they do that? Oh, come here. Come, bring me. Come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. Healed by the power of God. 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 Hallelujah. Well, I mean, Jesus did some really crazy stuff. Don't get crazy. Jesus did some really crazy stuff. Think about that. I mean, how many people would go to a spit in your eye, mud in your eye service? Not very many. But they missed the point. The book of Romans says that you have been eternally redeemed. Redeemed to return to the original state of affairs. Genesis chapter 1, Genesis chapter 2, before the fall. That's what he redeemed us to. He paid the price to purchase us back, to redeem us to the original. And I hear religious folks, I can always hear them raising their heads, hissing at me. Well, Brother Rod, the Bible says that the whole creation groaneth, to it the manifestation of the sons of God, the redemption of the purchased possession, our bodies. Now that's the silliest thing you could ever interpret that scripture to mean. God provided redemption for all three parts of you on the rugged, cruel cross of Calvary. When there was bleeding by which the very veins of God himself were emptied, when he was swung up between heaven and earth and the pitiful Palestinian sun beat down into his gaping wounds until it felt as though the very flames of hell itself had embedded themselves deeply within the flesh of the only begotten Son. God, who clothed the baby ravens and carpets the valley in green. God himself, who stood on nothing and said, "Light be," and light was. That God redeemed you. What he's talking about there is he's going to give you a new body, because everybody in this room is going to live forever somewhere. And in that moment, he will redeem your body if you're born again to the point that you can inhabit the throne of God, that you can live in a place called heaven. He will redeem your body to that point. He redeemed your body for earth when the first red rivulet, scarlet drop of precious eternal blood ran freely down a naked side and dripped off his toes into bloody pools upon the earth. It shouted with the very first drop, "You are healed." Redeemed. Bible said Peter and John went up together. Would you shout together? God is like really into agreement. It's like his thing. God gets really, really excited about agreement. Notice that Peter and John went up together. That's a certain number. Do you know that two can get what one never can? Well, I'm sure you're familiar with the scripture that says one will chase 1,000, but two will put 10,000 to flight. 300,000, 4,000,000. You know the scripture that says, "Whatsoever you shall bind on earth shall be bound in heaven." You notice the joining together of the earthly and the divine. The natural and the supernatural, the heavenly and the earthly. Whatsoever you shall bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. Whatsoever you shall loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. Do you believe we can bind and loose cancer and healing? Bind and loose depression and victory? Bind and loose sorrow and gladness? Do you believe it? I have an announcement for you, a staggering announcement. Matthew 18:18 does not belong to you. Shove your neighbor and say, "You can't have it." I don't mean to freak you out, trying to build your faith. Matthew 18:18 does not belong to you. you cannot, you are never promised that you can bind and you can loose. Never. It doesn't belong to you. Because Matthew 18, 18 is irreversibly connected to Matthew 18, 19. You want to know what it says? Do you want to know what it says or not? Mm-hmm. Put it up there, Katie. I'm looking for the first verse. Verily I say unto you. Next verse. Again I say unto you, that if any two of you on earth, that if any, where are they again? Here they are on the earth. If any two of you on earth shall agree as touching anything that they shall ask, it shall be done for them by my Father in heaven. Next verse. For whithersoever two or three of you are gathered together in my name, there am I in the midst of you. You have to have verse 20 before you can have verse 19, and you have to have verse 19 before you have verse 18. But if you get verse 20, if we can get two or three of you together gathered in his name, if somebody in here tonight believes that he's been given a name above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee will bow, every tongue will confess that he is Christ, to the glory of God the Father. Do you agree? Slap somebody a Holy Ghost high five. There's something you can get tonight you couldn't get before. Millions of people joining together by faith. Peter and John went up together. They went up not only together, they went up, and the Bible said there was a certain number. I dare you to shove your neighbor on the shoulder and say, don't mess up my miracle tonight, because I really need it. If you need it, shout right now. No, if you believe this is the night. Nobody doubting. Listen. It was a certain man that they came into contact with. A certain man, not just any man, a certain man. The Bible says the same thing, Dr. Lowry, about that little woman who for 12 years suffered many things from many physicians and was none the better. She had an issue of blood. She actually had gone, Father, in the name of Jesus. Lay your hands on your body right now, wherever you are led, lay your hands on your body. I bind every sexually transmitted disease now. 8,000 teenagers between 12 and 18 years of age got a sexually transmitted disease today. 8,000 young girls lost their virginity in this nation. It's an epidemic. And you say, but should I ask for God to heal me of that? After all, it was my fault. That woman with the issue of blood, history tells us, had a bloody discharge. She had a sexually transmitted disease. It was her fault. But I'm here to tell you tonight that God came to take off you everything the devil put on and put back on you everything that God can restore your virginity tonight. He can restore your dignity tonight. Father, in the name of Jesus, I rebuke every sexually transmitted. I pray for every woman that has committed murder through abortion, that you be healed now by the power of God in your mind. You know how that certain woman got healed? The Bible said she heard. God woke me up at 4 o'clock in the morning, 4 or 5 days ago, and he said the reason she heard was because she stopped listening. Hold on. The reason she heard was because she stopped listening. She stopped listening to those voices that screamed out unclean. She stopped listening to people tell her that she was. Stand up right there, that African-American gentleman right there. Stand up. You, stand up. Don't you know if you're African-American or not? Stand up. Yeah, you. Well, I didn't see your bow tie, or I could have. Step out in that aisle. Are you a pastor? I'm not discerning that. I can see you got a badge. I'm assuming that you're a pastor. God is about to increase the white ethnicity of your congregation 25% in the next 12 months. In the name of Jesus. Well, it's done. You can shout if you want to. Oh! Ah, come on. I feel a wave of the Spirit of God right now. Jump up out of your seat and high five somebody a different ethnicity than you right now. There's no such thing as a white church. There's no such thing as a black church. Shout! If you want to see racial reconciliation, don't look to politicians for it. Look at the church. I bind every spirit of bigotry. I bind every wound that has come into your life as a result of a racist comment given to you. In the name of Jesus, I set you free. I'm messed up. Yeah, I'm messed up. Be seated. She heard because she stopped listening. Who have you been listening to? She stopped listening to those that said they'd never be healed. Stand up, Austin. Stand up. Stand up. No, don't get sentimental. We're not about sentiment. Stand up, Austin. What's up, man? Austin, God told me this afternoon that when you speak to autism, thousands of people are going to be healed. Are you ready? Yes. Say, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
I come to you now. In faith believing. I bind the spirit.
Of autism.
I command it.
To loose these people.
And set them free.
In the name of Jesus.
Be healed. Don't stop. Get your blessing. For every neurological disorder, for Asperger syndrome, for autism, for PDD, for ADD, I bind every learning disorder in the name of Jesus. This is a Renaissance generation where we reach back to the tried and tested, proven powers of God available to generations in the past. We bring this generation into it. We speak an increase in the IQ of our children. We command new Michelangelos. Scientists and doctors, mathematicians. Lift your hand and claim your child for the kingdom of Christ right now. Lord, we just lose holy angels to sit at the foot of people's beds We command right now. Where's Matthew? Where's Matthew? Where is he here? Come here, Matthew. You're on the front row. I didn't know that. Come here, Matthew. Come here, Matthew. Matthew, your mother. How old are you now, Matthew?
31.
You're 31. Your mom and dad were pastors. But you were living underneath an overpass in Los Angeles, stabbing yourself in the arm with needles, snorting everything you could find. But your mother got a prayer cloth. She put it in your clothing. And when this young man went out to buy drugs, he went to three different drug dealers, and none of them would sell him any drugs. That's a miracle. Father, in the name of Jesus, we believe you to rescue every child addicted, every child bound, every child struggling. We claim them for the kingdom in the name of Jesus. Be seated. I'm sorry this gets on. I'm sorry. A certain woman decided to stop listening to what they were saying. And when she stopped listening to what they were saying, she heard what he was saying. It was a certain number, a solemn assembly, a calling forth of God to gather his people together to go to a certain place at the temple and find a certain man. That's you right now. But it was at a certain moment when I stepped into this year, the Holy Spirit said to me, Isaiah 43:19. Behold! Say behold. Now there are no brothers that when sisters came walking in this room tonight, would all the single people, that's people that are single, not every single person, but people that are single, raise your hand right now. Raise your hand. Everybody look around. Take a good long look. But you know, when brother walked in and he saw that fine sister tonight, he didn't say to the brothers with him, behold. Did he? I said, did he? When you rolled up next to that Mercedes at the traffic light that you've been believing for, you didn't look at your wife and say, behold. But you said, what the? Tonight is a what the. Behold, God said, I will. Tonight has really nothing to do with you and everything to do with him. Tonight has nothing to do with what church you go to or how you hold your hair or how long your sleeves are or how you comb your hair. Tonight has to do with the grace, the mercy, the passion, the power of a living Christ who simply set his watch and said, if you'll do what I say to do, if you'll gather together, I will. Tonight. I'll do a new thing. What is that? Something that's never existed before. I believe all around the world right now, things are happening that have never existed before. Never existed before. Creative miracles are taking place right now in the name of Jesus. Don't talk to me about creative miracles. I can show you children attending Harvest Preparatory School who have attended from kindergarten and graduated high school, and the doctors will tell you they were born without optic nerves and they still have no optic nerves. They're now working at Harvest Preparatory School. Don't talk to me about creative miracles. I'll show you a little boy. He's ushering here tonight. He was born without a cerebellum, and we brought him on this platform and prayed for him, and God grew a brain inside his skull. Get on your feet, get on your feet. I prayed for a woman not long ago. She said, I want to get pregnant. I said, are you married? That's a prerequisite. She said, yes, I am. Brought her husband up there, laid hands on them. She went back to the gynecologist that had removed her womb and her ovaries in a complete radical hysterectomy. When she went back to him, he threw his stethoscope down and said, I've got no explanation. Your ovaries are back, your womb is back, and you're 3 months pregnant. Reach your hands up here and shout. Believe for creative miracles right now. Believe for creative miracles right now. Listen. Listen quickly. Oh, God. Listen quickly. Oh, you can be seated. You can be seated. Say, behold, what the God will do something that has never existed before. And then he said that word now. Shout it again now. We know what now means at this moment, in this season, at this time. But the actual translation bears out that it means much, much more than that. The Bible says in the book of Ezekiel, what God does, he does forever. Here's what now means at this time, in this moment, in this season. And then he finishes up with henceforth and hereafter. That means that when God places one touch on your life tonight, it is irreversible. It is, your divorce papers are going to get torn up and you're never going back to the divorce court again. You're going to put the bottle. Oh, I can't talk. I can't talk. Say now. Now, henceforth, and hereafter. I want you to watch this. It's an unbelievable testimony. It's an unbelievable testimony. And while we're sharing that testimony with you, I want thousands and thousands of you that are watching right now to go to rodparsley.com or go to your phone. Dial that number on your screen. Dr. Lowry, God told me I would give one command and 100,000 people would be set free from homosexual and lesbian spirits. During a recent broadcast, I pointed my finger at the camera and I said, you lesbian spirit, come out. Two lesbians were sitting in a bed together, fornicating, drinking, watching Christian television to mock. And when I said that, the drink glass shattered in one of her hands. The other threw it across the wall and burst it against the wall. They got out of the bed. They looked at each other. They said, what are we doing? They gave their hearts and lives to Jesus. They moved out from each other. One's in Bible college and the other's already in full-time ministry preaching the gospel. Shout now! 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 Watch this powerful testimony.
Meet John and Carolyn Ellis from Fayetteville, Tennessee. Married for nearly 30 years, they loved the Lord with all their hearts. But it wasn't always like this.
I was raised in church. Both my mother and father took me to church regularly, every Sunday. But I lost both of my parents within 2 years of each other, tragically. And I got mad at God, and I just quit going to church because I actually lost my faith, I think.
More than anything, Carolyn wanted to see her husband saved. For 25 years, she never wavered in her faith or her prayers for his salvation. But John's heart had been hardened, and Carolyn's prayers just couldn't seem to break through until Carolyn decided to step out of the box and request a prayer cloth from Pastor Parsley's Worldwide Miracle Healing and Victory Service.
I received the prayer cloths in the mail, and here they were, and I thought, wow, this is great. So I put one under his chair, and I put the other between the mattress and box springs in the bed. And he didn't know that. And I prayed. And I says, Lord, I know that you can bring him. I can't, because I'd been trying for years. 25 years I'd been praying for him.
I wasn't ready to listen. I just wasn't ready. I totally turned against God.
I asked for his salvation. I said, I don't want to spend eternity without him.
I just could not wait to get to the front and confess my love for Christ that day.
He was literally jumping over people to get out of in that aisle, jumping over.
I didn't know it until after I gave my heart back to Christ that she had done this, you know. She had slid it under my chair and evidently between the mattresses on my bed. I did not know.
I firmly believe that God works through Pastor Parsley and through these prayer cloths that have been prayed over and anointed. There's power in those prayer cloths.
In my life, that's what I believe saved me. You know, I was hard-headed. I wasn't going to go back to Christ. It wasn't, but evidently Christ came to me. It had to be through the prayer cloths.
Ask, and it will be given. And I asked, and I knew that one day that he would come to the Lord.
That quick, I knew that Christ was there for me, and, you know, I just had to give up. I had to give him back what I'd taken from him.
Now he's going to go to heaven. And if there's a rapture now, he's going with me. It's wonderful.
John and Carol Ellis, stand up. Come up here, John. Come on with me. Bring your pastors with you. Bring your pastors with you. Come on. Wipe those tears, John.
They're tears of joy. They're tears of joy.
Thank you. Prayer cloth.
Absolutely.
Yes. You put it in his chair.
Yes.
That's kind of sneaky, yes. Carol.
Anything, whatever it takes. Whatever it takes.
I just saw that little testimony. And I saw the love between you two. I saw you there in your church, worshiping God, and beautiful tears coming. You know, probably more people have been hurt in church than anywhere else. And there are things we don't understand. Did you hear me? Charles Greenaway, one of the greatest missionaries that ever lived. His own son died with leukemia when he was but 8 years of age. They said, how can you continue to serve God? Has God given you an answer? And he said, no, I don't understand. And then he said something I shall never forget. He said, I refuse to lose out with God over a mystery. Lord, for all the wives believing for their husbands, for all the husbands believing for their wives, Father, we agree right now that the circle will not be broken. By and by, Lord, by and by. There is a better home waiting in the sky, Lord, in the sky. Reach out right now, your mighty long hand. Bring them into the kingdom, I pray. Bring them in. Don't lose hope. For in due season you shall reap if you faint not. It took a long time, didn't it?
Yes, it did. 25 years.
25 years. And then suddenly.
Within 6 months after I got that prayer cloth.
Would you give God praise? God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. No, no, no. Never again will you ever stand under the same anointing. For even this night, henceforth and hereafter, shall the healing power of God come upon you. And the prophetic word of the Lord shall flow through you. And great deliverance shall be at your command, says the Lord. Stand up, Dr. Lowry. Come here. Every preacher in this building, stand up. Every preacher in this building, stand up. Every preacher of the gospel. There's about to be a transfer of the anointing. This man traveled the world in a tent, seating 10,000 persons. And everywhere he went, the lame walked and the deaf heard and the blind saw. Dr. Lowry, I wouldn't give you 5 cents for the message of the gospel without the miracle. With message and no miracle, you have vain religion. With miracle and no message, you have empty emotionalism.
No right to preach it unless we can manifest it.
Say it again.
No right to preach it unless we can manifest it.
Every single preacher, run down here. Just preachers, run down here right now. Run down here. Only people that make their full-time living preaching. That's it. No one else, or you'll bind the Holy Spirit. Thousands and thousands of you watching whose ministries have been stolen. Adultery, drunkenness, weakness have come into your life. You are about to be delivered by the mighty hand of God, and your latter end shall be greater than your beginning. Dr. Lowry, pray over these preachers. Pray over the thousands watching. Loose that miracle anointing into their lives.
I want everybody in this great assembly to stretch out your hands and release your anointing.
Come on,
everybody,
these men
standing. Of God, turn it loose. Release it upon them tonight.
I want to hear you praying in the Holy Spirit right now.
And I pray that men and women that are watching on the internet around the world will stretch your hands this way. Something supernatural, something stupendous is going to happen in this house,
Jesus!
This moment. Get ready for it. Our God, in the name of Jesus of Nazareth, we release a double portion of your mighty anointing upon every man, every woman, every boy, and every girl, that they will go from this place.
Miracles.
Healing the sick, casting out devils.
Yes, God.
Raising the dead.
Yes, God.
In the name of Jesus, we release it upon them this night by the power of God. Let this anointing that is upon your servant flow into their lives.
Jesus, do it.
And that you will raise up all over this nation and world men and women with a supernatural
Jesus.
Ministry of the living God.
Now turn around
in
and
Jesus
join hands.
Name.
Come here, mother. Turn around. Come here, mother. Turn around. Stay here, Dr. Lowry. Stay here, Dr. Lowry. Marcus, you and Joni, come and join us, would you please? Joni, can you get through here? Joni, can you get through here? Come through here. Oh, I sense the anointing and the power of God. We must have miracles return to the church. We cannot surrender to a newfangled form of religiosity. God is calling us. Isaiah 8:18 declares, both I and the children that the Lord God hath given me are for signs and wonders. And God worked with them, confirming his word with signs following. Shall I receive it? Miracle ministry. I receive it. miracle ministry. Now you turn around and face this thing's getting out of the pulpit. It's getting into the pew. You're about to walk past those crippled in their legs between the frozen peas and the carrots in the grocery store. And God is about to stretch out their limbs by your very presence. You will convict the world of sin. Preachers, release miracle and healing and delivering power into those standing here tonight. We release miracles, healings, and deliverances into your life. Hear me. Not that you receive them, but that you work them. Oh my God. Oh my God. Look at another preacher right now and tell them, miracles are commonplace in your ministry. Miracles attract people to the gospel. Miracles confirm the resurrection with great power. Gave the disciples witness of the resurrection of Jesus. I loose resurrection power into every part of your life. Return to your seats. And you stay with me, Marcus and Joni, would you? Marcus and Joni, would you stay with me? Hallelujah. 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 Come. Come. Come, Joni. Come, my precious Joni. I want to say this. I want to say this. I want to say it under the anointing so that I am not confused. I want to say that the burning heart of evangelism has been my constant companion since 17 years of age. I have met what many would consider ministry elite. I have sat with them and talked with them and eaten with them. And so many times it rings so hollow. Ministry professionals. God found this young man who graduated summa cum laude from one of the most prestigious Christian universities in the world when he was 19 years of age. Placed upon him the mark of an evangelist. Then he met his lovely wife, Joni, who spells her name just like my Joni. Marcus and I were born in the same year. T.D. Jakes, Marcus, and me, and a 57 Chevy. And I want to say, for whatever it means, for whoever would be watching or hearing me now, I know no two people on earth more anointed of God, more sold out to God, more dedicated to God. And they are the most least pretentious people I've ever known. Joni currently has a best-selling book on the New York Times bestseller list. They've built the great Daystar network that spans the world. God will continue to use them. I could not be more honored or more proud to turn this service over to them to do with as they will. I sense an anointing to destroy every yoke and break every burden. The wonderful Daystar singers have traveled all this way to be with us tonight, and I want them to take their liberty. This is their house. On their network, they can do with it as they please. Would you tell them how glad they are? You are. They made it all the way to the great tabernacle of World Harvest Church.
Well, let's give God the praise and God the glory. The Daystar singers are coming up. You know, we've already sensed the glory of God. But my experience has been that it just gets stronger and stronger and stronger. We are changed from glory to glory. And I believe something is building in this house tonight. It's such an honor to be here, you know, to be at World Harvest Church, to be with Pastor Rod and Joni, their wonderful family, Ashton and Austin, and Sister Ellen, God bless you. She's going to be my amen corner tonight. I know I can count on her, and hopefully many of you as well. But miracles are going to happen in this place tonight. They've already begun. They're happening across the airwaves, across America, and around the world. Open your heart and expect to receive, and know that God is going to be faithful who hath promised. Well, the presence of the Lord is here. Without further ado, would you make welcome Joni Lamb and the Daystar Singers. Amen.
Such an honor to be here. Such an honor to be here. Don't you love your pastors, Rod and Joni Parsley, of this house? Yeah, you can do better than that. Amen. And we can't forget Mama Parsley either, can we? No. It's such a wonderful presence of the Lord here. We want to continue in that same atmosphere and just open up your heart and receive. This is the partial Daystar Singers. We didn't bring all of them, but again, give honor to this incredible music program that you have here. It is amazing. We just are so blessed by you guys. You certainly don't need the Daystar Singers, but we are honored to be here. And just open up your heart, continue in the same atmosphere of worship as we sing a couple of songs for you. We're going to start off with one Eddie's going to lead out, entitled Steel. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Mine rests, my soul.
Father. You know, Pastor Rod was talking about 2007, and so many of us can relate to some difficult times in 2007. But 2008 rolled around, and of course we all know 8 stands for new beginnings. Marcus was preaching in London for Pastor Matthew Ashimolowo, and he preached a message entitled, "You Can Begin Again." And that's what this song talks about. While he was preaching, our own Joe Nanowski began to write this song. Raise your hand, Joe. Wave at everybody. He's the music director at Daystar. He had his computer, and he just began to write this song. And this song has become a signature, not only for those who are here, but those who are watching by television. This is a message just for you today. Listen carefully. Thank you.
For every child of God who's had a moment in time where you maybe doubted, this song is for you.
'Cause you can begin again. You can begin again. You can believe. You can be healed. You can be free again.
And here's why.
For God is here.
Begin again,
you can begin again.
Oh yes, you can.
You can begin again.
Oh yes, you can.
You can believe.
You can believe.
You can be healed.
You can be healed.
You can be free.
You can be free again. So God is here. Tonight.
You can begin again.
Oh yes, you can.
You can begin again.
Oh yes, you can.
You can believe.
You can believe.
You can be healed.
You can be healed.
You can be free again.
For God is here.
That God hasn't forgiven you. But the devil is a liar. God never knew anything about you that right now that you don't understand, that you know. God knows everything that you've ever done. He knew it before you were born, and he knows it right now. There's no surprise in Christ. So you've tried everything else. Why don't you try Christ tonight? Why don't you give him your all in all? Don't you know that he deserves it?
Best is yet to come for me.
Just sing it out.
Best is yet to come for me. The best is yet to come in my life.
Somebody gotta believe him today.
See, the best is yet to come for me.
Speak it.
The best is yet to come for me. The best is yet to come in my life.
Come on, sing it like you mean.
Standing on your promises,
standing on your promises,
for life.
today. You can begin again today. It's God's time. It's God's will. And it's God's way. Just wave your hand and sense His presence in this place today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God bless you today. You may be seated. I want to suggest that you can take Joni and the Daystar Singers home with you tonight. Now, the best way to do it is to take them home by CD. So they'll have some of their CDs in the eastern part of the building, the foyer after the service. All of them will be back there and they'll be signing them. And Joni will be back there with her brand new book entitled Surrender All. It was published by Random House, which is the largest secular book publisher in the world. That's my son, Jonathan. And I will say, like God said, this is my beloved son in whom I am well pleased. He just graduated from ORU with a business degree and feels called to help his mom and dad out. And we need his help. Amen. But anyway, here's Joni's book. It is a tremendous book. People are reading it all over the world. You'll laugh. You'll cry. You'll find out more about Joni and me and about Daystar and about many, many other people, some famous, some infamous, some not so famous. But every area of your life, I promise you, something in this book speaks to it. And Joni is going to be personally autographing these books after the service in the eastern side of the building. I sense the glory, the anointing of God. I'm only going to preach just a very few short minutes. I promise you that. But today is a day of miracles. So I want to show you a miracle in just a moment. It's about 3 minutes long. And it'll let you see a part of what Pastor Rod Parsley is a part of, what Breakthrough is a part of, and what World Harvest Church is a part of. And in just a few months, Daystar will be coming to Columbus, Ohio on Time Warner Digital Cable. The contract has already been signed. Of course, I realize many of you watch already here by DirecTV or Dish Network, and we also have a medium power station, Channel 19. So this is a three-minute piece about Daystar, and you want me to tell you something? It's a miracle. You're going to see a miracle unfold before your eyes. In fact, Pastor Rod, a continuous miracle. And let me tell you something neat about what you're about to see. Just a few days ago, this three-minute video that was done entirely by our Daystar staff won an Emmy Award. I don't know if any Christian television's ever won an Emmy before, but Daystar won two. And one of them was for this video. So they can dim the lights. Let's watch this, and then I'll be right back ready to preach the Word of God. Amen.
Experience.
We have the greatest message on the face of the earth.
Changes.
Jesus came and preached a new kingdom.
Everything.
This is our time. This is our day.
Experience Daystar.
The divine light of God has illuminated the human spirit and set a person on fire.
Top international ministries, award-winning original programming, contemporary network packaging, the biggest names, and more live events than any of its kind.
From Atlanta, New York, Chicago,
Washington, D.C.,
Philadelphia,
Miami,
Jakarta,
Rio de Janeiro,
Beijing,
every city in America and every country in the world.
Colombia,
India, Pakistan,
Venezuela, Honduras, Peru.
On cable, internet, satellite, DirecTV, Dish Network, and mobile phones.
Paris, Moscow, Cape Town, Sydney, Hong Kong,
Kiev, Singapore,
India, Estonia, Finland, France, Germany.
Every people, every town. Every nation.
Daystar is the second largest, fastest growing faith-based network in the world. Daystar state-of-the-art facilities offer one of the largest special effects studios, 17 sets, high-end post-production, a top-of-the-line digital console, two audio suites, and an in-house recording studio.
We've gone to a great deal of effort to create something of excellence.
Daystar's on-air quality is second to none, and faith-based television will never be the same. Children, teens, today's generation. With over 100 national and international programs combining the biggest names of faith and entertainment, Daystar is tearing down the walls of denomination and race.
We must be vision-driven, not memory-driven.
Music, movies, events, inspiration. And it doesn't stop there. Groundbreaking original programming is what we're known for. Celebration, Joni, Gospel Music Showcase, and Soundcheck are just four of the standout hits in Daystar's award-winning lineup. Today's headlines, hard-hitting relevant topics, and much, much more. And now, Daystar.com offers an online experience that's the first of its kind. Viewers can post content from anywhere in the world and enjoy video on demand, dynamic downloads, podcasting, program information, and inspiration.
Keep watching Daystar. Keep being blessed.
If you want to get closer to God than you've ever been before, you're in the right place.
The Holy Spirit is drawing people.
God will never disappoint you.
He always causes you to try.
I am who God says I am. I can do what God says I can do.
We are the army of God, and we are more than conquerors through Christ.
Entertaining high-quality programs, award-winning originals, every multimedia platform, and more live events from around the world. Everything is about to change. Daystar. Experience it.
All right, can you give God all of the glory? He deserves it all. If you have your Bibles tonight, I want you to turn in the New Testament to the book of Ephesians, chapter 3, verse 20. Ephesians chapter 3, verse 20. I want you to know that this service is being broadcast into every city in America and in every country of the world. And if you've just tuned in, we are in Columbus, Ohio, at World Harvest Church under the leadership of Pastor Rod and Joni Parsley. Hallelujah. Ephesians 3 and 20. Every word of this verse is a recipe or a formula for a miracle. Now unto him that is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we can ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us. Pastor Rod Parsley, I'm excited about the very first verse because it gives us the time of our miracle. He said, now, and you so eloquently explained to us the greater meaning of that word. God is a God of now. God is a God of today. Yes, I thank God what he did in yesteryear, what he did when grandma was a little girl. I'm excited about our future and eternity and all that God is going to do. But I suggest to you tonight that God is here. He's a right now God. He's an on time God. He's a present God. He's a current God. He's a God of today. Everybody shout now. Exodus 3 and 14, I am that I am have sent thee, Moses. Psalms 46 and 1, God said that he is a very refuge, present help in time of trouble. Therefore will not we fear, though the earth be removed and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea. In Malachi 3 and 6, he said, for I am the Lord thy God, and I change not. And the first verse I learned as a little five-year-old boy in Macon, Georgia, in Sister Eula Mae Peavy's Sunday school class, Hebrews 13 and 8, Jesus Christ the same yesterday, today, and forever. Psalms 118, 24, this is the day that the Lord hath made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it. 2 Corinthians 6 and 2. Now is the accepted time. 1 John 3 and 2. Beloved, now are we the sons and daughters of God. Somebody shout now. Now unto him. Well, I wonder who him is referring to. Well, it's not talking about the one that's in the White House or the one that's about to be in the White House. He didn't say now unto your doctor. He didn't say now unto your lawyer. He didn't say now unto your accountant. He didn't even say now unto your employer. But he said now unto him. But who is he talking about right there? Well, I'll tell you who he's talking about. I'm talking about the one that created all things. He commanded the sun and the moon to stand still, and they move not. He controls the order of the universe with the wave of his hand. He puts planets into place with the tip of his finger. He used lightning as a sign of his son's second coming, and he used thunder to utter his voice. He used the rainbow as a sign of his covenant between him and man, and he used the rod to separate the Red Sea. And my goodness, he used the rod of God to build World Harvest Church in Columbus, Ohio. Do you know who I'm talking about today? He used the jawbone of a mule to slay 1,000 Philistines. He used a man's shadow that if they fell across the sick, the dumb would speak, the deaf would hear, and the lame would leap for joy. He used a man's handkerchiefs and aprons that the sick and afflicted were healed and delivered and set free by the mighty power of God. And he's going to use some 300,000 prayer cloths on the platform of World Harvest Church in Columbus, Ohio, to release a series of miracles across America and around the world. And if you haven't gotten your prayer cloth yet, call the number that's on the screen or go to rodparsley.com and claim one for your own. It'll be prayed over tonight and it'll be sent to your house. I'm talking about now unto him. I'll tell you who he is. He's the one that calls and ordains prophets. He used a donkey to rebuke a prophet, and he used a rooster to rebuke a disciple. He used a raven to feed a prophet, and he used a dove as a sign of his life after death. He used a little boy to speak to a high priest, and he used a harlot to save the life of a nation. And that same wonderful God is still using men and women, boys and girls across America and around the world to do mighty exploits in his name. If you know who he is, shout praise the Lord. I'll tell you who he is. Why can't the God that stopped the sun in the sky and sent the manna from on high, laid flat the walls of Jericho and turned to fight on Israel's foe? Can he not answer prayer today and drive each stormy cloud away? Why can't the God that healed the sick and healed the helpless crippled spine said to the tempest, peace be still, and the hungry multitudes he did feel? His power is just the same today, so why not let us labor, watch and pray? He conquered in the lion's den. He brought Lazarus back to life again. He heard Elijah's cry for rain, and he freed the sufferers from their pain. If God could do those miracles then, why not let us prove our mighty God again? Why can't the God that raised the dead and gave David great Goliath's head cast out demons with one word, yet sees the fall of a wee small bird, do signs and miracles today in that same old-fashioned way? He can, he will, he's just the same today, and he will hear us when we pray. God's no respecter now of men. He'll do the same as he did then. I wish somebody would shout, he's able. Oh, he's able. But who am I talking about? In John 1 and 1 and continuing, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. And all things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehendeth it not. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. The same came for to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. But he was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of the light. That is the true light that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came into his own, and his own received him not. But to his men many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them which believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of flesh, nor of the will of men, but of God. And the Word was made flesh. I said, and the Word was made flesh. I said, and the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory. The glory is of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. For the law was given by Moses, but grace and truth came by Jesus Christ. If you know who he is, give him a shout of praise today. Now unto him that's able. Somebody shout, he's able. You're watching by way of television. He's able. He's able to heal your body. He's able to save your soul. He's able to put your marriage back together again. He's able to take care of you financially. He's able to bring that wayward son back home. He's able to touch the heart and heart of that daughter and soften it to the things of the Lord. I'm telling you, he is able. 2 Chronicles 25:9, for the Lord is able to give you so much more. And the Bible says in Daniel chapter 3 verse 17. And Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego said to King Nebuchadnezzar, O king, our God whom we serve is able. He is able to deliver us out of the burning fiery furnace, and he will deliver us out of thy hand, O king. Matthew 3:9, for God is able of these stones to raise up children unto Abraham. If you hadn't got it yet, I'm preaching on he's able. In Matthew 9:28, and Jesus said unto the blind man, believest thou that I am able to do this thing? In Romans 4:20-21, for he staggered not at the promises of God through unbelief, but he was strong in faith, being fully persuaded that what he had promised, he was able also to perform it. In 2 Timothy 1:12, for I know in whom I have believed, and I am persuaded that he is able to keep that which I have committed unto him against that day. Shout it again. He's able. Hebrews 2:18, for he is able to help them that are tempted. Hebrews 7:25, wherefore he is able also to save them to the uttermost, them that come unto God by him, seeing that he ever liveth to make intercession for them. God said unto Moses in Genesis 18:14, is there anything too hard for me? In Job 42:2, I know that thou canst do everything, and that no thought can be withholding from thee. And in Matthew 28:18, a word came. It didn't come from a prophet. It didn't come from a disciple. It didn't come from an angel, but the Son of God himself declared, all power is given unto me, both in heaven and in earth. Ladies and gentlemen, I came all the way from Dallas, Texas to Columbus, Ohio tonight to tell you he's not just the God of the heavens, but he's the God of this earth. He's not just the God of tomorrow. He's the God of today. And now is the time of your miracle. Now unto him that is able. Somebody shout it again. He's able. Oh, what is he able to do? He's able to save you. James 1:21. Wherefore, lay apart all filthiness and superfluity of naughtiness, and receive with meekness the engrafted word, which is able to save your soul. Not only is he able to save you, he's able to sanctify you. Dr. Lowry, some of us still believe in sanctification. Some say it's an instantaneous work. Some of us say it's a growing grace. It's a gradual thing. I think it's both. But John 17:17, sanctify them through thy truth. Thy word is truth. Not only can he save you, not only can he sanctify you, but he's able to fill you. In Acts 10, 44, 45, 46, 47, and 48, and while Peter yet spake these words, the Holy Ghost fell on all of them which heard the word, and they of the circumcision were astonished, as many as came with Peter, because it on the Gentiles also was poured out the gift of the Holy Ghost. And how did they know? For they heard them speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. He's able to give faith unto your life. Romans 10, 17. So then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. He's able to give you a miracle. My favorite New Testament verse, I like to put my name in there and personalize it because I consider it a letter from my Father. You can put your name in there too, but here it is. John 15 and 7. Dear Marcus, if ye abide in me, then Marcus, you can ask whatsoever you will. And Marcus, it shall be done unto you. That word, little word abide, means to live with or to come alive or to take up residence within you. So when the Word of God becomes alive, when it's alive in you, when it takes up residence in your life, it fills your mind, it fills your thoughts, it fills your emotions, it becomes a way of life. That's when you can call on God and the miracle will be on its way. My God, I'm almost through preaching here. I want to tell you about a miracle that happened. Sometimes preachers are prone to exaggeration. They take literal that scripture that says, call those things that aren't as though they be. And they get to telling stories sometimes that can be tall tales. Well, I'm just a short preacher, so I'm not going to tell a tall tale. I'm not only going to preach a short message. Don't say amen too loud about that either. Well, it's January 1978. Everybody say 1978. I am preaching in the sprawling metropolis of West Monroe, Louisiana. I'm preaching at a church on Montgomery Street. And Dr. Lowry, you know the pastor who was there at that time, Reverend J.C. Dudley. I'm preaching along in that service, and while I'm preaching, I'm going around and I'm shaking people's hands as I preached. And as I got down over to this, on the left side of the church, on the second row, there was an elderly man. And I reached over there, Sister Joni Parsley, to take him by the hand, and the man didn't respond. I thought, oh, he must not like me. So I just reached down and grabbed his old bony hand anyway and just shook it. And when I did, Miss Ashton, he screamed. Or since I'm from Georgia, he hollered. Now, y'all in Ohio don't know what that means, but that's a Georgia term. He hollered. I thought, my goodness, I'm just the little Lamb of God. I know I couldn't have squeezed that man's hand that hard to make him want to scream. And he kept on hollering. I thought, this is out of order. He's disturbing my service. Well, I got through with the sermon, and I went over to the Hammond B3 organ with the Leslie speaker. And I began to play what they call a postlude. Now, the prelude, that's the song at the beginning of the service that's soft and melodious and makes people feel warm and they enter in into worship. But a postlude is at the end. It's kind of like the exclamation point, and it's a happy, joyful song so the people will leave feeling good. Just in case Ma Parsley, the preacher, didn't do so good, they'd still feel good about the service. Well, since I was the preacher, I wasn't so sure I'd done so good. I hit that Hammond B3 and I played with everything I had. I started playing Hallelujah Anyhow. Well, anyway, all of a sudden, Reverend J.C. Dudley. Now, where was I preaching at? West Monroe, Louisiana. The intelligence factor of World Harvest Church is at an extreme high. preaching in West Monroe, Louisiana. Pastor J.C. Dudley comes running down the aisle. And he was about 5'5" tall and about 5'5" wide. And evangelist Harold Woodson, as he come running down the aisle, I saw him out of the corner of my eye. And he reached down and grabbed the top of his britches because his belly was bouncing like that. And I think he was afraid he was about to lose them right there in the service. Thought, my God, revival will break out in this place if that happens. Well, he come running up there and he was... He was speaking in tongues, and as Isaiah 28:11-12 says, for with stammering lips and another tongue will he speak to this people. And he says, I said, Brother Dudley, will you quit speaking in tongues? I said, the anointing has left me, and I have no idea what in the world you're trying to say. Can you please speak in English or give the interpretation one? He was trying to tell me. Finally, he gained his composure. And he said, do you remember walking over there in the middle of the service? And you grabbed that elderly man by the hand and he began to scream. And you quoted that verse from Psalms 107:20. So then he sent his word and it healed them and delivered them from all of their destructions. And you remember that man began to scream and begin to holler. I said, yes, sir. How could I ever forget? Well, he said, the thing you didn't know is that is Virgil Graves. And 12 years ago, he had a stroke and he was paralyzed on his entire right side. He couldn't move his arm and he couldn't move his leg. But Virgil Graves just walked down the aisle of this church just as tall and straight and strong. And he stuck out his hand and said, put it here, Pastor Dudley. I'm healed by the power of God. He said, when that little evangelist grabbed me by the hand and he quoted that verse about God's word healing and delivering, he said, I heard the voice of God saying, son, I've healed you by my word. And when that word of God came through my understanding, I felt something like fire run down my shoulder, down my arms, down my hands, and down the ends of my fingers. And the healing power of the living Christ was mine. I want you to stand to your feet and praise the Lord all over this place and shout, he is able. Hallelujah. I want Joni and the Daystar singers to come up here right now. Hallelujah. I want them to come up here right now. I feel faith rising in this place. I sense the anointing of God in this place. If you need a miracle, call the number that's on the screen. If you haven't gotten a prayer cloth yet, Pastor Rod Parsley has so generously said, I'm praying for prayer cloths that haven't even been accounted for yet, besides the hundreds of thousands who have called in or written in. So in other words, there's still time for you. And if you call that number or if you go to rodparsley.com, you can request the prayer cloth. And just a few minutes after this altar invitation, Pastor Rod Parsley and the thousands of people of World Harvest Church at one of the largest prayer meetings in the history of mankind, as people in every city of America and every country of the world that are viewing this broadcast are going to join their heart and join their faith and dare to believe God for your miracle. I want the music to begin to play, David Ribb. I want Joni and the singers to get ready to sing. I realize that the majority of this audience tonight are believers. Ladies and gentlemen, there are some among us that aren't right with God. And I believe I would be remiss if I didn't give you an opportunity. Just begin to play the music. Go ahead and start it. I believe I would be remiss if I didn't give you an opportunity to get right with the Lord. If you're full of the Holy Spirit and the power of God, begin to plead the blood of Jesus. That's the most powerful prayer that can be uttered by the lips of a man to a holy God. And say, God, get a hold of every man, every woman, every born girl that's in this place that needs to get right with God. Every head bowed and every eye closed. Tonight, God is watching. God is looking. He knows you're going in. He knows you're going out. He knows everything about you. And he knows whether you're ready to meet God tonight. Let me ask you a question. If your heart were to stop beating, if your lungs were to quit breathing, are you ready to meet God? If you stood before God tonight and he said, why should I let you into my heaven? What would your answer be? What would your response be? There's some of you that used to know the Lord. You used to be on fire for God. You used to sing the high praises of God. The joy of the Lord permeated your soul and overflowed your vessel. But you've allowed the cares of life. You've allowed the things of the world. And you've allowed sin to creep in. To now Satan has literally stolen your song. Some of you are bound by pornography. You're enslaved to pornography on the internet. Others of you, they're bound by drugs and alcohol or fear or depression. You need to be delivered and set free tonight. Tonight, if you know you're ready, there's no doubt in your mind. You say to God, God, if I didn't get to pray another prayer in this life, I know I'm ready. Lift your hand while no one looks but me and God. God, I know I'm ready. There's no doubt. Hold that right hand up and just wave it to God in glad thanksgiving. But what about you that can't raise your hand? Now take your hands down. If you couldn't raise your hand, but you say, preacher, pray for me. I want to be ready. I want to go when the rapture takes place. I want to live eternally in heaven. I don't want hell to be my home. I want heaven to be my everlasting home. Pray that God will be merciful to me. Pray that God will be patient with me. Pray that God will give me another chance that I can make things right before my time comes. Well, I know every eye is closed and every head is bowed. If you want my prayer and you want God to be merciful to you, lift your hand up so I can see it. Lift your hand up. God, I want your help. I want your mercy. I want your grace. I want your forgiveness, God. All right, now take your hands down. Everybody look at me. If you need to pray, if you need to get right with God, I want you to step out. Come down and stand in this altar and meet me here right now in Jesus' name. If you need to pray, if you need to get right with God, come on. You lifted your hand. You said, God, be merciful to me. You said, God, give me another chance. You said, God, spare me until I can get right. Oh, it's no accident that you're here. This is no coincidence. It's a divine setup. You've got a divine appointment with God tonight. Tonight's your night. This is your time. Now is the time of your salvation. Come, come, come. He's calling you. If you need to pray, the altar is not a place for bad people. It's a place for good people, people that love God, people that want to get closer to God, people that want to give their life to God, people that want to dedicate their heart to God. Come in Jesus' name. Come in Jesus' name. From the front to the back, from the left to the right. Preacher, I need to pray one more time. Preacher, I want to be sure. Preacher, I need to make things right with God. He can set you free tonight. You can walk out of this place a brand new creature in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. The Holy Spirit is speaking to me. There's still about 25 more people that need to come. And we're not going to tarry this altar. In just a moment, I'm going to turn this to Pastor Rod Parsley. I'm going to ask every Spirit-filled believer to one more time lift your right hand and plead the blood of Jesus. There's somebody that God brought you here for such a time as this. God sent me here tonight to preach to you and to give you this invitation. And God is saying you don't have to walk into 2009 like you entered 2008. Things can be different. As the Daystar singers sang a while ago, you can begin again. You can begin again. If that's you, step out now quickly, quickly, quickly. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I'm going to count from 10 backwards. And when I get to zero, we're going to close this altar call. Church, keep praying. If you need prayer, call that number that's on the screen. 10. Come in Jesus' name. 9. God's calling you. He's calling you. 8. step out in Jesus' name. Seven, there's still room at the cross for you. Six, this is God's time for you. This is your night. This is your night to be set free. You don't have to be enslaved to the bondages of sin any longer. God can set you free. Five, He's calling you. Four, He's calling. Come. Yes, you're making the right decision. Three, just three more numbers between you and an eternal destiny, either in heaven or in hell. Two, He's calling you. One, I'm getting ready to call this last number. If you feel the Holy Spirit tugging at your heart, step out now in Jesus' name. Oh, Pastor, they're still coming. They're still coming down the aisles. You need to be set free. You call the number that's on the screen in Jesus' name. All right, while they're still calling, look at me just a minute. I want to give you a scripture. And then I'm going to pray with you. Then I'm going to turn this service over to Pastor Rod Parsley. 1 John 1:9 says, if we confess our sins, that doesn't mean to name everything wrong we've ever done. It just means to acknowledge that we are sinners in need of a Savior. If we confess our sins, then He, Jesus Christ, is faithful and just to forgive us of our sins, and here's my favorite part, and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. So I'm going to lead you in a prayer. I want you to pray the prayer after me. I want you to say it out loud if you're comfortable in doing so, but at least say it in your mind. Say it in your heart and mean it. If you're in a hotel room, I want you to pray this prayer with me. If you're in a hospital or a nursing home or a prison, Daystar is on in every prison in the state of Texas. It's an absolute miracle of God. We just spent $1 million to do that. You may be in the privacy of your home, but pray this prayer. Say it out loud after me if you can, or at least say it in your heart. Dear Lord Jesus, I love you today. And I believe that you love me. And that you died on the cross. And you shed your blood for my sins. Lord, I know that I'm a sinner. And I've made many mistakes. But I'm asking you to forgive me today. Come into my heart right now. I accept you by faith. Now thank you, Jesus, for loving me. Thank you, Jesus, for forgiving me. And thank you, Jesus, for saving me. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen and amen. Now would you just lift your hands to the Lord and thank Him. Thank Him today. In your own words, begin to love Him. In your own words, begin to praise Him. From your heart, tell Him how much you love Him and how wonderful He is. If you prayed that prayer with me, call the number that's on the screen or go to the website and say, I prayed that prayer. We're going to send you a free gift that'll bless you, that'll help you with the rest of your life. It's important to testify. Revelation 12:11, and they overcame Satan by the blood of the Lamb. That's Jesus' part when He died on the cross. And by the word of your testimony, that's your part when you tell somebody. Just before Pastor comes, all over the world, people know that lifting your hands is the universal sign of surrender. Just like Joni's new book, Surrender All. I want you to do that right now. I want you to lift both of your hands heavenward as if to say to God, I surrender. I surrender. I give up. Here I am, God. Not only take my heart, but take my life, take my mind, take my abilities, take my talents, Lord. Use me for your glory. And Lord, fill me with your precious Holy Spirit that I'll have power to live for God and to work for God and to serve God. Now wave those hands to the Lord as Pastor Rod comes. to take this service. Lord, I receive your touch. I receive your blessing. I receive your Holy Spirit. I receive the breakthrough in my life that I need. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Now praise him in Jesus' name.
Lift those hands. Lift those hands. Say, I'm forgiven. No, say it so you can hear it with your own ears. I'm forgiven. And it feels so good to be free. I could almost shout. Oh, why not? Those of you watching by television, make sure you dial that number on your screen. Folks get astounded, Marcus. They get astounded. They give an altar call. They don't even preach a sermon about salvation, but they give an altar call. You always give an altar call. Always. Look at this. Now, I have to share with you, this is not unusual. I just told you nearly 6,000 people in between 6 and 7 weeks' time have been right here at this altar. You say, well, looks like you'd have to build a church of 30,000. Well, I didn't say they all ended up in this church. I'm not trying to build a church. I'm trying to build the kingdom of God. I'm throwing out the lifeline. I've built many churches in Columbus, Ohio. Hallelujah. Pastors all over the city say, he just wins them and my church explodes. Hallelujah. But I thank God, Marcus, for you and for Joni and for the Daystar Network that put souls ahead of anything else. And with such compassion and such love, we must move people first to compassion, then to wisdom, then to duty. Let us give God thanks for this man of God and tremendous ministry to bring in this great harvest of souls and many thousands more watching by television. Those of you in this altar, there's someone standing next to you who just became your best friend. They're going to follow you all the way back to your seat so we can get your name, because look around, you're on purple carpet. You're not on streets of gold. We want you to make it all the way to heaven, and we're going to help you do that. So fill that card out. They'll follow you back to your seat or all the way to your car if they need to get that card filled out. So back to your seat you go right now. Listen, hey. Not you. I was talking to the other people. Y'all go back to your seat. I'm talking to the people in their seat. This service is not over yet. I got a prayer left in me, and I got 300,000 people here believing for your agreement. So as these return to their seats, and as we get ready to release the miracle working power of God around the world and to you right there in your seat, get ready now. Get ready now. Where's Tiffany? Is Tiffany here? Yes or no? Yes. Tiffany, come sing me a song. Come sing me a song. While these are returning to their seat, while you begin to pray in the Holy Spirit, if you don't pray in the Holy Spirit, just believe God to receive the baptism in the Holy Spirit right now while they're singing. And then I'm coming to pray, and we're coming to believe God for worldwide miracles in Jesus' name. Shout yes! Hallelujah. Tiffany, do your best.
Exceedingly, abundantly above all you could ask or think, according to the power that worketh in you, you
want you to look at your neighbor and I want you to sing this. Say, God.
God is able to do
just what he
just
said.
What he said.
He would do.
He's
able. He's
able.
He's
able.
He's able.
blessing. I'm losing my home for every single person. They said that by January, nearly 25% of the homes in America will be in foreclosure. I choose not to participate because he's able. Give our jobs back. Give our money back. I dare you to shout, put it back. Put it back. Claim a better job. Claim your retirement account to prosper. Command the stocks that you own to prosper. Show you. Rebuke every demonic spirit. I plead the blood of Jesus. I plead the blood of Jesus. Cancer. Marriage. Financial. AIDS. Rebuke it. Let weakness lie limp on the shoulder of God. Our God is able. Let them throw Daniel in the lion's den. He'll reckon his position, turn his face toward Jerusalem, offer his prayer to the Father, pillow his head in the shaggy mane of the lion, and sleep like a baby all night long. For he knows his God is able. If you believe he's able, shout yes. Shout now. Now salvation. Now deliverance. Now healing. Now prosperity. Now. 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 Father, for every request, breakthrough. Breakthrough. Deliver. Heal. Set free. You are God. Besides you, there is no other. And we bless you. And we declare for every one of these needs, you are able. Show yes.
Yeah.
person that has hurt you. Forgive every person that has wronged you. Ask God to cleanse your lips and turn around and tell somebody, I bless you. Do it now. Is a liar. What?
The Lord said to me a few moments ago that if one touch will change everything,
yes,
forever, what will one seed do?
God woke me up 6 months ago and He said, there is a seed that changes everything. A seed.
A seed.
When humanity was lost and separated from God,
my God,
God said, I'm going to send a seed. I'm going to send a seed.
Yeah.
It is the nature of a seed to die. When you need a miracle, God will always give you an instruction.
Yes.
The instruction that you choose to obey will determine the future that you create. God always has, God does now, God will forever deliver with the power that is resident in a seed. Seed is important, soil is important, but season is paramount. Do you know what verse came to me while I was standing back here? Marcus preached it. I've been preaching on the now season all year. Your Bible says, send now prosperity. It did not say, send prosperity now. The now describes the kind of prosperity. It is an adjective. It describes the noun. It's the kind of prosperity. It is now prosperity. Prosperity that has a now anointing on it changes your situation, not only at this moment, in this season, at this time, but henceforth and hereafter. When the seed came, humanity was redeemed forever. The seed changed everything. Be seated. Be seated. Harold, I don't know what the Lord has spoken to you, but I know this. My son is on the front row praying for other folk.
The whole service.
My son.
Ah.
My son, the doctor said, would never go to school. But he's in the eighth grade and he's never made, he's in the 10th grade. Hey, listen, I'm under an anointing. He's a junior. Whatever grade that is. Is that 11th grade?
11th grade.
I'm more drunk than anything else. My boy, peas don't mean much unless they're your peas. They said he'll never go to school. Is that right? Well, he happens to be in 11th grade. He happens to have a 4.3 grade point average. He's never made a B in his life. The devil is a liar.
How?
When they said that about my son, I said, uh-uh. Joni and I joined together. We agreed.
Yes, sir.
To agree for your daughter tonight.
Yeah.
Who's never put on her own clothes. Who's never fed herself. whom you've never heard say your name. But I got news for you tonight. God is able. My son prayed tonight.
Yeah.
And thousands of people were set free. The devil is a liar. God told us, sow a seed. Make it the most significant seed of your life. Mix your praying and your giving. And that's what we did. And that's what we do every day. Why are you sitting there looking at me like you don't need a miracle? This is the year of eight. This is where we're turning seven to eight. Do you know what eight is in Hebrew? It's shemone. That's what it is. Shemone. Look at you. God has healed you tonight. God has healed you tonight.
Yes, sir.
This man was one of the best friends of Nicky Cruz, running the streets of Los Angeles. And in the Jesus movement, God got a hold of him. But things from back then have come and now tried to kill him. And the devil is a liar. I don't care what time it is. I believed all year for this service. And somebody is about to get the greatest miracle of all. Because eight, shemone. Do you know what it translates? The year of superabundant fertility. God said there's never been a year to sow in like this one. And that's why this economic thing has hit. To try to keep you from sowing. And the devil is a liar. I'm about to freak you out. You don't sow on a mountain. You sow in a valley. Isaac sowed in a recession and in the same year reaped a hundredfold. Don't say you don't have a seed, you do. And some of your needs can only be represented by an $8,000 seed.
Yes, sir.
Why are you looking at me cross-eyed? $8,000 isn't enough to meet your need. Must be a seed. $800, $80, $18. Am I perspiring? Is that why you're handing this to me? Sow your way out. I don't know what Harold's got to say. Sow your way out. This is a year of an election. You get to vote this year. Raise your hand. Raise your hand. Vote right now. If you believe Jesus is Lord of all, raise your hand. Okay, you get to vote. Vote now. Are you voting? Okay, now take that hand and reach in front of you and get one of those white envelopes. Everybody. Harold?
If that one seed shows the proof tonight, I mean, I'm sitting here shouting. I'm crying. I'm laughing. I'm watching Austin. I'm watching him minister to people. I was here a few years ago when that first seed was sown, and I see the proof of it tonight. But you see, they're like you. You've sown seed and sown seed. But tonight, you came to this house tonight so that one touch would change everything. And God said, one seed, there is a seed that you possess. Some of you, it's $8,000. Some of you, it's $800. Don't try to ignore it. I don't know who you are, but I know the kind of miracle I've got to have. I didn't come here just to come. I've got to have a breakthrough. I've got to have God show up. Is there anybody here that's got to have God show up? Is there anybody here that's got to have God show up? Then I want to say to you right now, as we transition, when you're watching this, we've already shifted from seven to eight. And if you're here tonight, right now, there is a seed that you possess that will change
everything. I know it by the Holy Ghost. I want every one of you that believe and you know that God's ready to change something, raise your right hand up right now, and for the next 15 seconds, begin to pray out loud in the Holy Ghost. Just begin to pray out loud in the Holy Ghost. Begin to pray out loud in the Holy Ghost. Begin to pray out loud in the Holy Ghost. Now stop. You just heard a few moments ago the word from the man of God for tonight, for this season, for your change. There's a seed that you have right now. Start reaching right now. Get your checkbook. Get your credit card. Get your check card. Do whatever it is you do. Reach and get that envelope right now. We're not going to wait and see who will do what. God brought you here tonight to declare to you that one seed will change your entire position. There's a seed that you have. You don't have to wish for it. You've got it tonight. If it's 8,000, if it's 800, if it's 80, if it's 8, whatever it is, reach and get it right now, right now, right now, right now. Now, as quickly as you can, hold that seed up. Hold it up. Hold it up. Hold up the envelope. Hold up the check. Hold it up. Lift it up. Lift it up. I say this out loud. Lord Jesus, I've seen a miracle tonight. I've tasted a miracle tonight. I'm expecting miracles tonight. I came because I believed. And now I point my seed toward my need. And I expect a change in the name of Jesus. I declare it to be so. I declare it to be done. Now shout like you believe it's a done deal. No, shout like you believe it's a done deal. Hallelujah. Give him a hallelujah he hasn't heard tonight. Give him a shout he hasn't heard tonight. Now when you put that seed in, the ushers are coming right now. When you put that seed in, begin to shout for your breakthrough. Begin to shout for your breakthrough.
He's gonna tell me.
See, you see him on Celebration and on the Daystar Network, but you don't get to hear him preach. I don't have much voice in it, but if I was him, I believe I'd have me a preaching program on there, where I showed great preaching like that from such a man of God. I'm a gospel preacher, and I love gospel preaching. And that is gospel preaching. And I love you for it. I want you to stop back there in the east foyer. That's this way. And Joni's back there signing her New York Times best-selling book, I Surrender All. It'll be a great blessing to you and your family. Dr. Tia Lowry, sir, you have honored us by your presence here tonight. We thank God for you. All of the wonderful World Harvest Church Ministerial Fellowship members under the direction of Mother Parsley, we are so delighted you are all here tonight. I think we had about 50 of them stalled in airports around the country that couldn't get in here, but we thank God for them. To the eldership, the leadership, the staff of the 11 major ministries that function out of this little eight-walled tabernacle around here, thank you. God bless you all. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you, lift up his countenance upon you, and give you peace now and forever. And I hope you can't go to bed for singing, He's Able.